reputed university, and because of those professors, because of that particular university, today we know what we call IT revolution. And today if you go to the Silicon Valley in the US, in our country, which place is called Silicon Valley? Bangalore. Actual Silicon Valley is where? In the US, California state. And courtesy, Stanford University. We'll go back to the passage. Stanford scientists have new steps. Have new steps. What is the word? I'll read out the options. Have outlined new steps. Seems right, hold that one. Have configured. Configuration, does it go with steps? I don't think so. It goes more with instruments and gadgets. So mark the second option wrong and write the combination, configuration. Brackets write instruments. Configuration goes with instruments. Usually instruments, sometimes gadgets, but usually instruments. Described, alienated, underline the word alienated. I think I gave the word yesterday. Alienate means what? Isolated. Please write the meaning of that word. Alienated means isolated. It goes with tribal people. It goes with minorities. They're not part of the mainstream. Then what do we say? They got alienated from the mainstream culture. Not relevant here. Expanded. No. What is the actual sentence? Stanford scientists have new steps. Underline new steps. You are left with what? Outlined. Described, expanded. But generally they talk about new policies or new steps. Here we use enumerate, outline, highlight. These are the words that are used. Based on that, what is the answer? The first option is the answer, outlined. It is not configuration ruled out. It is not described, alienated ruled out. It is not expanded. Have you got it right? Shall I go to the next one? So Stanford scientists have outlined new steps that 143 countries around the world can take to attain, underline the word attain. Attain means what? Achieve. Write the meaning of that. Achieve. Attain success, achieve success, accomplish, all are related words. You could also write the word accomplish. Achieve, accomplish, attain, positive word. 100% clean renewable energy by 2050. The roadmap, please underline the expression roadmap. Write the meaning of that. A roadmap means a plan or strategy. Please write plan or strategy. You all know the word strategy, right? Plan or strategy for a particular goal. Please write plan or strategy for a particular goal. You have a goal, you have a project. To make that project a reality, to make that goal a reality, you have a strategy. What is that strategy called? A roadmap. You all must be knowing this word. Yes or no? Fine. The roadmap, published in the journal One Earth, uses the latest energy data available in each country to offer more guidance. Underline the word guidance. Guidance, which part of speech is it? Please write noun. So the word before a noun, which part of speech? It has to be adjective. We'll use that knowledge. Restricted guidance. Guidance is positive or negative? Positive. Restricted, negative. So mark it wrong. Ambiguous means what? Vague. Is it positive or negative? Negative. So mark it wrong. Precise. Precise means what? Exact. Write the meaning of that. Precise means exact. Hold that one. General guidance, but they are university professionals. You cannot use the word general. Improper, positive or negative? Negative. So what is the answer here? The third option, precise guidance, means what? Exact guidance for what? On what? On how to reach those commitments. It comes 10 years after the publication by scientists of the first plan for powering the world with wind, water and solar. What are these actually? What do they go with? Energy sources, renewable or non-renewable? Renewable. What is the other word for renewable? Conventional or non-conventional? Conventional, non-renewable. Non-conventional, renewable. Don't get confused. Conventional, write the word conventional. Conventional means what? Traditional. Write the meaning, conventional, traditional. Conventional, bracket, right? Non-renewable, fossil fuels, conventional, non-renewable. Then you, below that you write non-conventional, means not traditional, and bracket you should write renewable sources of energy, like what? Wind, water and solar. Shall I continue? The roadmap includes new countries in its analysis and accounts for recently built clean, renewable infrastructure. Please underline the word infrastructure. What comes under infrastructure? Roads, buildings, power, water and transportation. Five things come under infrastructure. Roads, buildings, transportation, mode of transportation, water and power. In some countries, it calls for the electrification of all energy sectors for increased energy efficiency leading to energy use. This is a bit confusing. First, you underline the expression energy efficiency leading to. Energy efficiency leads to what? Increase of using energy or decrease of using energy? So you need a positive word or a negative word? Negative word. Reduce, not increase. What is the option? What are the options here? Reduced. Reduced. What is the, where is the sentence? For increased energy efficiency leading to reduced energy use. This seems right. Hold this one. What is the second option? Cut down. Can you use cut down here? No. You, if at all you have to use cut down of energy. Off should be there. Do you see the word off? No. Enlarged. Does it go with energy? Not the right word. Rise. Rise also takes the preposition of. You don't see that and it is not relevant here. Grow, again, not correct. So what is the answer here? The first option, reduced. Increased energy efficiency leading to reduced energy use. I hope you are able to follow that. And for the development of wind, water and solar infrastructure that can supply 90% of all power by 2030 and 100% of all power by 2050. The new model that the efficiency of electric and hydrogen fuel cell, the new model what? Dissuades, that's an important word, write the meaning of that. It's a negative word. Here you need a positive word or a negative word. Positive or neutral, but not a negative word. Write the meaning of the word dissuade. Discourage. Discourage, don't stop there. Discourage from doing something. Please complete. Discourage someone from doing something. And it always takes a preposition. It always takes a preposition from. Remember that. Dissuade takes a preposition from doing something. Has anyone got a question? No. Okay. So, dissuade, a negative word, not correct here, mark it wrong. Proves. Can you use the word proves here? No. What is the third option? Suggest. This seems right. What is the sentence? The new model suggests. This seems right. Hold this one. The new model opposes. Negative word, not correct. The new model, model doesn't prefer. We prefer a model. So you cannot use the word prefer. What is the answer based on that? The third option, suggest, is the answer. It looks difficult, but all the five you can get. I think one more is there. Am I right? Vehicles over fossil fuel vehicles of electrified industry over fossil industry could substantially, underline the word substantially, write the word substantial. Substantial means considerable. Please write considerable. And write one combination. Substantial improvement. Substantial improvement means what? Considerable improvement. That's a typical combination. Substantially decrease energy use. The efficiency of electric heat pumps over fossil heating and cooling, along with the elimination of energy needed for mining, transporting, and refining fossil fuels, please underline the word refining, will have the same what? What are the options here? Oh, this is a very good blank. What is the first option here? Effects. Please write two words. First you write the word effect, then you write the word effect. Answer my question, the first word effect, which part of speech is it? Noun or verb? Please write verb. What is the second word? It is a noun as well as a verb. But usage point of view, we don't use it as a verb. We use it as a noun. Rarely we use as a verb. But it is a verb. Now, that based on that, can you consider the first option? Mark it wrong. What is the second option here? Effects. Effect, singular. What is the plural of that? Effects. Hold that one. Causes. Can you use the word causes here? No. Origins, not relevant here. And beginnings also not relevant. So what is answer? The second option, effects. Where is this sentence? Will have the same noun you need. So same what? Effects. Have you got it right? So overall, how is this passage? Easy or difficult? Is the mic on? Easy or difficult? How many of you say easy passage? Raise your hands. Okay. How many of you say a tough passage? Raise your hands. Others, may I know what you're doing here? No response at all. It is an easy passage for a person who reads the newspapers regularly, for a person who reads the magazines regularly. I know some students must be thinking, oh, master has started the same song. No choice, I have to do that. So if you are not a regular reader of magazines and newspapers, obviously you cannot relate to the context. Then it takes more time and you may get out of five, two or three right. But you are a regular reader, you read the newspapers, magazines regularly, day in and day out. What happens once you see the context is about renewable sources of energy? This is in the limelight, right or wrong? Sometimes in the mains paper, descriptive paper, they ask you to write about renewable sources of energy. And you should have the information at your fingertips. And if you are in that situation, this one reading, you will be able to get the right words and all the five correct. It doesn't happen, nothing to worry. Still, you have 1.5 months time and try to compensate. Shall I go to the next set of questions? What do they deal with? Para-jumble. A bit difficult, but the context is very easy. These guys are a little smart in the sense, now slowly summer, winter is over, onset of summer. So summer, what do you expect to have? Or what do you want to have quite often? Either soft drinks or ice cream. So perhaps they have thought of that. What is the first sentence here? We have a lot of new students, so we will take elimination approach. Yesterday I did not do that. I will ask the question, you respond. Freeze for at least 6 hours, not you, but whatever the material, or until firm, keep stored in the freezer. Can it be the first sentence? No subject, mark it wrong. In the bowl of an electric mixer, whip the cream until stiff peaks form. Can it be the first sentence? No. Have you got the correct order the same way, or you have thought of some word? Something is missing here. So which letter is missing? Please add the letter for God's sake. P-O-U-R. Pour it into a resealable container. Okay. So can it be the first sentence? No. Cover the surface with plastic wrap and then seal. Cannot be the first sentence. On low speed, mix in the condensed milk. Cannot be the first sentence. So what are you left with? This is all about that. To make ice cream at home, what are you supposed to do? You can get the first sentence, absolutely no problem. What is the first sentence? To make ice cream at home. Now the problem, you are damn sure the second sentence cannot be A, cannot be C, cannot be D. Then you have to decide between B and E, to be or not to be. There's a saying. So how many of you have chosen E as the second sentence? Raise your hands. And how many of you have chosen be as the second sentence. Oh, that's wonderful. Answer is not because of the hands. Answer is be. Be is the second sentence. Be is the second sentence, but difficult to make out. Not at all easy. In the bowl of an electric mixer, but there is a clue. I will tell you where it is. In the bowl of an electric mixer, whip the cream until stiff peaks form. Then you can get the third sentence. What is the third sentence here? E is a third sentence. Here in the second sentence, please underline electric mixer. Electric, then you can talk in terms of high speed, low speed. In this sentence, please underline low speed. That is a continuity of thought. On low speed, mix in the condensed milk, vanilla and any flavorings. So you got three sentences. After that, it becomes rather easy. What is the fourth sentence? C is a fourth sentence. Pour into a resealable container. What is the fifth sentence? D is a fifth sentence. Cover the surface with plastic wrap, then seal. And what is the last sentence? A is the last sentence. Freeze for at least 6 hours or until firm. Keep stored in the freezer. So what have we learned? How to make ice cream? Am I right? Who has got the correct order? Raise your hands. Oh, wonderful. You can make nice ice creams then. You're ready for that. Now we'll go to the next. How many questions here? 5 questions and related to what? Single pillars, rather easy, but you should understand the context. Shall I read out question number 11? Some students already disconnected, shall I? Thank you very much. Le Radford, name of a lady, is now a vice president at Procter and Gamble. We don't say a vice president, please correct that to the vice president, the chairman, the MD, not a vice president. Le Radford is now the vice president of at Procter & Gamble, but she started, a lady, but she started her at companies in turmoil. Please underline the word turmoil. What is the meaning of? First you write one combination, political, turmoil. The symbol means what, that word? Political turmoil. So what is the meaning of turmoil? A disturbed state, or also write problematic state. Problematic state. A disturbed situation, a problematic situation. Political turmoil is a regular, typical combination. But here, companies in turmoil means what? Companies in trouble. Companies in a difficult situation. Easy one. So what is the answer here? It cannot be her course. Students do a course, but this talks about a profession. So reject the first option. Her field, does it make any sense? Irrelevant, mark it wrong. Pilgrimage, that's a good word, but it doesn't go with youngsters like you. It goes with old people like me. Pilgrimage means what? Pilgrim, please write the meaning of the word pilgrim. What is the meaning of pilgrim? Some people, they are highly devotional. They are devotees. You know the word devotion, devotional, devotee. And usually old people, they work their entire life. They get retired, no work to do. So what is the best thing to do? Visit temple so that at home no one gets disturbed. Otherwise, what happens? A lot of, please write the word, nagging. Old people are known for what? Nagging. Nag means what? They tell something repeatedly. Do this, do that, don't do this, don't do that. That is called nagging. So these people are happy and those people are also happy. They visit a lot of temples. They visit a lot of temples. That person, whoever visits temples, what is the word for that person? Pilgrim. And they visit a lot of holy places. Please write the word holy. A lot of holy places. Then what is a trip called? Imagine someone goes from this city to the north. They visit all the temples in the north. And that trip is called what? Pilgrimage. Please write the word. pilgrimage. Nani, please keep reminding. Whenever there is a disturbance, please remind. I will do that. There is a problem with this. So, pilgrimage means what? Visiting holy places on a single trip. Visiting holy places on a single trip. Does it go with this lady? Does it go with Procter and Gamble? Certainly not. So mark it wrong. What is the next one? Avocation. You may not know the meaning of this particular word. Please put a star mark. And what do you think the meaning of that? Is the mic on? Thank you. So please respond. What do you think? I haven't said what is the meaning. What do you think? Not vacation. Please write one meaning. It means hobby. Avocation means hobby. Write another meaning. Minor occupation. Not major occupation. Minor work, minor occupation. But generally, avocation means hobby. Someone's hobby, we say. Hobby goes with everyday English. Avocation goes with effective English. Have you got the meaning of that? Is that the word? No. So what is the last word here? She started her career at companies in turmoil. What is the answer? The fifth option is the answer. An easy one. One reading you should be able to make out. Small schools across the United States are what? Budget shortfalls, underline that, negative. And low enrollment, negative. Leading some to shut down in the middle of students' higher education experience. What is the, please underline the helping verb to be are. The United States, small schools across the United States are experience. Can you use the word experience? No. You need a verb in ing form. How many options are there? So reject the first option, reject the fourth option, reject the fifth option. It should be either facing or fighting. Can you use the word fighting here? So what is the answer now? That's right. Wonderful. You're responding pretty well. I appreciate that. A first of its kind. Please underline the expression first of its kind. That's a very good phrase to use. A first of its kind youth apprenticeship program in Colorado. Please underline the word program. What is the spelling of program? So is this right or wrong? It is right, but make a note. American spelling is what? P-R-O-G-R-A-M. British spelling is what? P-R-O-G-R-A-M-M-E. This is also right, but American spelling. Exam point of view, it is not right. So better you mark it wrong and write the correct spelling. P-R-O-G-R-A-M-M-E. Exam point of view, we don't consider American English, we don't consider conversational English, we don't consider modern English or current English. If I ask you the question, family members, is it right or wrong? Immediate answer. But the Hindu paper, first page, you see the expression family members. So who is right, the master or the Hindu paper? You will say the master. Why? I'm in front of you. You can't afford to say the Hindu paper. That is ruled out. Jokes apart, the Hindu paper, the ultimate newspaper, standard English, still we should not consider. What is the reason? That goes with current English or modern English. That is not valid from the exam point of view. What is valid from the exam point of view? Standard British English. According to standard British English, it is members of family, not family members. That you have to remember. So, shall I continue? A first of its kind youth apprenticeship program in Colorado. Colorado, again, one state in the US, aims to students further industries of the future, underline the word future, by mirroring a successful model in Europe. What is the first word here? Aims to make students spur. Does it make sense? Mark it wrong. Aims to arrange students spur. Again, no. Appoint students spur. No. What is the next option? prepare students, write word, you can definitely answer this one. And this is ready students for, not correct. Prepare students for industries of the future. I told you to underline the word future. Please write one expression. Futuristic. This is you. Futuristic industries. Write one more combination. Futuristic technologies. Futuristic industries. Futuristic technologies. I think in the first five questions, close, one word, refining. Remember, I told you to underline. Yes or no? I wanted to tell something. First you write the word, refined. Answer my question, what is the meaning of the word refined? Please write polished. Purified, also write purified. Refined means what? Purified. Purified. So in the past, when refined oil was new to this country, a lot of Indians, they would go to a grocer, one who sells provisions or groceries. They would ask for, they would say, I want refined oil. What is refined oil? That is a typical Indian expression in the past. What they meant, I want refined oil. But they would say refined oil. There's nothing like refined oil. Does it make any sense? So that goes with common errors. But this word has got another meaning. Please write one word, sophisticated. What is the meaning of sophisticated? Sophisticated goes with people. Where is this Nani? Is he here? Please ask someone to come here. It is too thick. Can you make out the spelling? Sophisticated, have you written? Some problem is it has to be thin. Shall I write again? Please write sophisticated. Here it looks much better. Bracket you write person. Sophisticated person means what? A refined person, polished person. Can you polish a person? Not possible. Here polish has a different meaning. Please write the meaning of that. Sophisticated means civilized. Write the word civilized. First you write the word civilized. Then you write the word, this is what you wanted to say, urbane. Please write the word rural, urban, different words. But here, urbane, what is the spelling? B-A-N-E, means sophisticated, civilized, polished. Also write the word elite. What is the spelling of that? E-L-I-T-E. The rich and famous of a city. So you got the answer. Shall I go to the next one? What is the question number? 14. The jewelry company credits a hip-hop inflected ad campaign. Hip-hop, underline that. That goes with what? Dance, one type of dance. If you say we don't know, I'll be shocked. So it goes with young people, young generation. Hip-hop inflected ad campaign for its. So it sounds positive or negative? Positive. What is the first word here? Arrival. For its arrival? No. For its advance? Doesn't make any sense. For its success? Hold that one. For its failure? Negative. For its loss? Negative. So what is the answer here? For its success. Easy one. All stories in newspapers. You don't have to read the options. Newspaper, what is the word? Publish. So what is the answer based on that? The fourth option. All stories published in newspapers. But we'll check other options. Announced, easy word. Disclosing. Please underline that word. Answer is the fourth option. I'm trying to do value addition. Please write the word disclose. That's very good. Whoever has said that. Also write the word divulge. Make public. Disclose, reveal, divulge. They're all synonyms. Means what? To make public. Remember these words, they are important. Shall I go to the next question? So five over. The next set of questions, what do they deal with? Misspelt or inappropriate words. Am I right? Or it is a replacement. Wrongly spelt. Faced with the messy realities. Underline the word messy. Do you find any error here? Okay. Entrenched. Realities of entrenched. Any error? I'll give the meanings later. First we'll see the answer. And privilege. What is the spelling of privilege? Please write P-R-I-V-I-L-E-G-E. And generally we use it in the plural form. Please add the letter S. And write the meaning of that word. Privileges means exclusive rights. Please write the meaning. Privileges, exclusive rights, R-I-G-H-T-S. Privileges of the members means what? Exclusive rights of the members. What is the next one? Solution. Any error? No. So what is the answer here? The third word, privilege, not correct, properly spelled. Now write the meaning of messy. First you write the word mess. Mess has many meanings. As a noun, you all go to the mess regularly. Okay? No one enjoys the food, that's a different story. Then you write the word mess, brackets, you write verb. And write one, mess up. Write the expression mess up and write one sentence. Don't mess up with me. Don't mess up with me. That's an example. Don't mess up with me. If you see English movies, quite often they say, don't mess up with me. If you mess up with me, I will mess up with you. So what does it mean? Don't trouble me. Don't disturb me. If you trouble me, I will trouble you. So you got the meaning. From any movie, that dialogue is there. Which one is that? Oh, that's okay. You have become so active. Now we'll go to the next one. So, in a mess, sometimes what happens, the bachelor's rooms, they're not properly arranged. Things are not properly arranged. Don't look at me seriously, generally speaking. Then we say, his room is in a big mess. Someone's room is in a big mess means what? Things are not properly arranged. If things are properly arranged, what do you say? Everything is in apple pie order. Apple pie order. One expression. What is the second expression? Everything is spick and span. Spick and span also means neat and tidy. I think you have got these already. Yes or no? Fine. Shall I go to the next question? What is it? A focus on high selective schools obscures. Underline the word high. At the outset, you cannot decide. So you have to read the entire sentence. A focus on high selective schools obscures. Underline that word. The experience of the vast majority of American undergraduates. What is the next one? Majority undergraduates. Do you find anything wrong with obscures? Anything wrong with majority? Anything wrong with undergraduates? No. So the first word is not correct, grammatically speaking. Spelling-wise, it is right. What is the correct word here? High or highly? Please add L-Y. Highly selective. It should be highly selective schools. This is not easy at the outset. You have to read carefully. Shall I go to the next one? Unwritten rules underlie. Please underline the word underlie. Before that, write the word obscure. That's a good word. Obscure means what? First you write not clear. Then you write vague. Also, you could also write mysterious, obscure, mysterious. You cannot understand. Shall I continue? Okay. Next one. unwritten rules underlie. Underlie means what? They form the basis of something, the foundation. So write the meaning of that. Unwritten rules underlie means what? They form the basis of something. Underlie what? All of elite university life, underline the word elite, I've just given that word, and students who don't come from a wealth background have a hard time navigating them. You all know the word navigation, navigating. It is in the limelight. But here, please underline the word background. Background, which part of speech is it? Right, noun. The word before that has to be what? Adjective. Wealth is a noun or an adjective? It's a noun. What is the adjective form of that? So what is the correct word here? Wealthy background. That is the right word. Wealthy background. And write the part of speech adjective. Even, shall I go to the next one? Even as selective schools open their doors to a wider array, underline the word array, of applicants in the early 20th century, they put policies in place to maintain the advantages of wealthy white students. Any problem with students? Any problem with policies? Any problem with array? That's an important word. Please write the meaning of that. Array means a range. Array of something means a range of something. Range. I've written the word, you can have a look. Range, array. Array of applicants means what? A range of applicants. Any problem here? No. Selective? Any problem? So what is the answer? The fifth option, what is it? All correct. Is that the fifth option or fourth option? Fifth option. No problem with this. Even as selective schools opened their doors. You cannot say selected schools, selective schools. Is that the last one? That's it. Over. Now 20 to 26. Thigga undamma kondiga thincha. Relax for a minute. We'll continue after that. But don't go out. Ink color yellow. Annotation. Thickness, ink thickness. 8 unda idi. Shall I make it 6?
4 undi manaku.
4. Okay. No problem. So shall we? 20 to 26 passage. What is this passage about? It should be inspiring for all the girls. It is about a doctor. This lady, the first Indian woman to travel to Antarctica and stay there for 16 months, Dr. Kamal Wilku. She is a Punjabi, I suppose, and now she is 71. She still works as a doctor in Punjab, and she is quite healthy. 71, she still wants to offer her services, and she got selected for that visit to the South Pole. At what age? 51. So it was in news that time. Have you read this passage? We'll see a few words. The first Indian woman to travel to Antarctica and stay there for 16 months, Dr. Kamal Wilku, spirit of adventure. Please underline the expression, spirit of adventure, can be gauged. It has many meanings, gauge. How do you pronounce that? Gauge. And in this context, write the meaning, to assess or to evaluate, gauged from, assessed from the fact that she was 51 when she was selected for the expedition. At the age of 51, we don't feel like going from Hyderabad to Delhi. Am I right? And at the age of 51, imagine someone being a lady that too was ready to go to the South Pole and spend how many months? 16 months with a lot of men in the group. I think she was the only lady. Because of that, she had a few problems. I read the article in the newspaper. I wanted to know about this lady, why she was, why a passage about this lady. Then in some interview she was talking about, I was the only lady in that expedition, and a lot of members of that expedition, they initially did not interact with me. They tried to give the cold shoulder and the maintained distance, but later it was all okay. She enjoyed the trip. Shall I continue? So, gauged from the fact that she was 51 when she was selected for the expedition. My father's words still echo. Please underline that word. You all must be knowing that, not a big deal. In my ears, he used to say that age should help, not hinder education. That's a very good quote. Please underline, age should help, not hinder education. Wonderful. Highly inspiring. So the South Pole, Antarctica, is a very harsh continent. Please underline the word harsh. I'm trying to give the meanings of important words from the passage. Would you like to have the words or you want me to give the answers? Words, okay. Harsh. Please underline the combination, harsh continent. There's a question based on this. If you don't read the question meticulously, you will get the wrong option. So put a star mark, continent. Here it is not climate, harsh continent. Continent is different, climate is different. So do remember, when we go to questions, I'll talk about this. But write the meaning of harsh. In this context, harsh means what? Not comfortable. Please write the meaning. Harsh means not comfortable to live. Not comfortable to live or to stay. Not at all comfortable to live or to stay. So harsh continent, says Dr. Wilku. There are no inhabitants. Underline the word inhabitants. You all know the word inhabitants. But that is not the point here. Value addition, a particular place or a continent, original inhabitants are there. Imagine. Then what are the two effective words that go with original inhabitants of a particular place? One is aboriginals and the other one is what? Indigenous people. Write two words. One is indigenous. Why I am doing this, a lot of new students are here. I want those students to get benefited. Senior students know these words, but I see a lot of new faces, so they should also get benefited. What is the word? Indigenous people. Also write aboriginals. Aboriginals. Then you could write the meaning, native people. So what is the meaning of indigenous? What is the meaning of aboriginals? Native people or local people or original inhabitants. Have you got the meaning? Okay. So inhabitants, and all one sees are miles and miles of snow. The temperatures can sink too. You could also write the word dip. Please write the word D-I-P. Sink. In this context, we can use dip, D-I-P. Dip to -60 degrees centigrade in winters. Imagine -60. Can you imagine? Difficult to imagine also. So -60 degrees centigrade in winters and remain around -20 in summers. Summers -20, that is strange. There is no sunlight for 3 to 4 months in winter. Conversely, underline the word conversely. Converse here means what? Opposite. Converse, opposite. In summers, daylight can stretch round the clock for months. Underline the expression round the clock. Round the clock means what? 24 hours. Please write the meaning of that. Round the clock, 24 hours. So no sunset for how many months? For months together. Therefore, in summers, they had thick curtains to lull themselves. That's a good word. Please write the meaning of that. It has two different meanings. You all must be knowing lullaby. Have you heard of this any time? So who does it? Mothers. Mothers, they sing lullabies to the babies so that they sleep. You all know this word. But in this context, lull means what? A quiet time or a quiet period. Quiet period. Before the storm or after the storm, before something negative, after something negative. There's a time when things are very quiet and calm. And that time we use the word lull. So two different meanings. But in this context, it has a different meaning. There's a question also. Lull themselves into believing that it was dark and time to go to sleep. In winters, they had special lights that emitted rays like sunlight to help them distinguish between day and night. After the dark winter, the first sunrise is celebration time for teams of all countries. At the Indian station called Maitri, there are individual rooms, a large dining room, library and common area. Heaters run by a powerful generator provide warmth and water is pumped from a nearby lake. There is complete camaraderie. That's a very good word. Please underline that. Camaraderie. Write the meaning of camaraderie. Camaraderie means mutual respect. Mutual respect. And also write friendship. Mutual respect and friendship. Camaraderie. Not a regular word, among team members, says Dr. Wilku. Every team member has to contribute to the work. That includes clearing of snow and garbage. Disposal. You know the word disposal? Fine. I used to cook food for the entire team on Sundays. The most memorable part of their stay in Antarctica, she says, was seeing what? Aurora Australis, that is a phenomenon in the South Pole. North Pole also, there is a similar phenomenon. I think there is a different word for that. A separate word is there, which is a celestial phenomenon. Please underline the word celestial. I think you got the word celestial yesterday. What does it mean? Whatever you see in the sky, those bodies, celestial bodies. Please underline the word phenomenon. Answer my question. Is it singular or plural? Immediate answer. It is singular. What is the plural of that? Phenomena. That you have to recollect. Phenomenon of beautiful dancing lights in the sky in different colors and shapes. She also remembers the penguins, skuas, all these, and terns. Terns are birds, migratory birds. They have mentioned that also. Migratory birds whose going away heralds. Please underline the word herald. Herald means what? Indicate the beginning of something. Mark the beginning of something. Please write the meaning of that. Mark the beginning of something. Here in this context, beginning of winter. And coming back means summer. It is one of the most environmentally friendly places in the world. Pollution is unheard of on this white continent, she says. As per an international environment treaty, it is mandatory. Underline the word mandatory. Mandatory means what? Compulsory. Upon all teams to keep the area pollution free. We had to burn our garbage and bring even the ashes back to India. That's wonderful. You're not supposed to leave the ashes also behind. Now we'll see the questions. Find word from the passage which mean the same as the word or phrases to calm by deceiving. What is the answer? Is it believing? No. Is it hinder? No. What is the third option here? So the context talks about believing that winter was on or summer was on by closing, using the blankets and all. So what is the answer based on that? The third option is the answer. Have you got it? Shall I go to the next one? Find a synonym for the word heavenly from the passage. Easy to answer. What is the first option here? Celestial. Heavenly. Whatever we can't reach or whatever we see in the sky, we consider heaven. Heavenly bodies. Write the expression heavenly bodies. Heavenly bodies means celestial bodies. Please write. Heavenly bodies means celestial bodies. Other options are rather easy. Find antonym for the word, please underline antonym. Find antonym for the word enmity, animosity from the passage. Blizzard, that's an important word. Please write the meaning of that. Do you know the meaning of this word, blizzard? Okay. Please write. Snowstorm. Blizzard means what? Snowstorm. If you go to Alps, if you go to the North Pole, you go to the South Pole, you experience blizzards. Blizzard means what? Snowstorm. Disposal. Camaraderie. What is the question about opposite? Opposite of what? Animosity, enmity, antagonistic behavior. And what is opposite? Friendly. What is the meaning of camaraderie? Mutual friendship, mutual trust, mutual respect. So based on that, what is the answer? The third option is the answer. Team is not correct. Why does Dr. Wilkoe describe Antarctica climate as a very harsh climate? This is a tricky question. What is the answer? Please tell me. I'll read out the options. She had to cook food for the entire team on Sundays. Mark it wrong. All one sees for miles around is snow. Yes? There are no inhabitants. Yes? Please respond. The temperatures fall to minus 60 degrees in winters and in summer to minus 20 degrees centigrade. Now, based on that, what is the answer? What is it? B, C, D. How many of you have thought B, C, D? Raise your hands. That's why I said this is a tricky question. That is wrong answer. I'm serious. Answer is only third option. What is D? Let me check. The temperatures fall to a minus 60 degree. Answer is only D, third option. Why? I told you some questions. Will you allow me to speak? Shall I? Some questions, you are under tremendous pressure. You take things for granted. You read the questions. The flow is there. All of a sudden, they give a question where you have to read meticulously, respecting every word. But we have taken things for granted. And we assume, here, please underline the word, Antarctica. And what is the next word here? It is not continent. What is the word here? Climate. Climate, can you use the word snow with climate? I don't think so. Inhabitants, no. Climate, only one option stands out, goes with climate. Which one is that? Temperatures. So based on that, what is the answer? Who has got this only D? Raise your hands. I appreciate those students. That's wonderful. Others, no need to feel bad. Shall I go to the next one? We are running out of time. Dr. Wilkoe's spirit of adventure can be gauged by what? Her cooking to the entire team? No. Enjoying the sight of Aurora, Australia? No. Getting selected to Antarctica expedition at the age of 51. Obviously, so disposing garbage, that is ridiculous. What is the answer here? Okay. How can you say Antarctica is pollution free? Antarctica abides by, that's a very good word. Please underline, abide by means what? Follow the rules. Please write, follow the rules. Also write one expression, law-abiding citizen means what? A person, a citizen who follows the law, respects the law. Law-abiding citizen. So Antarctica abides by the International Environment Treaty. Right or wrong? Are you guys here? 45 minutes over, then I have to ask this question. Are you here? So answer is what? We can consider the first option mentioned at the fag end of the passage, perhaps the last sentence or last but one sentence. And what is the second option here? Garbage is burnt and brought back to one's own country. Mentioned. What is the third option? Because India built Indian Station. No, not relevant. Powerful generator pumps water from nearby lake, not relevant. So what is the answer here? Answer is the first option A and B. Which of the following sentences is true with respect to passage? Dr. Kamal Wilkie is very young. No, 51 you don't say young, at least in our country. But you go to the West, you know what they say? When I was young, that time they would say, Westerners, life begins at 40, that time. Now they say, life begins at 60. Till 60 they work, then they start enjoying. For them, youth, 60. For us, youth, 20, 30. Our guys, 30, get married, 35, they say, life is over. And you can expect the complete transformation, a big tummy and different body language. And they start saying, I am now thinking only of my kids. They stop thinking of themselves. Not right. What is the second option here? Antarctica is visited by migratory birds during the change of seasons. Terns, migratory birds mentioned in the passage. Hold the second option. Every country has a station in Antarctica. Has it been mentioned? No. Team members use curtains to protect themselves from cold winds. No. What is the answer here? The second option. Migratory birds. That's it. Passage. Now the last three questions. What are these about? You have to replace. You get one, then you can get the pair. Shall I read out the first one? The principal driving force preserve. Can you say driving force preserve? No. What is the other word? Underline preserve. Meteorite studies fact. The principal driving force fact. Does it sound right? No. And what is the third one? Generally we say the force behind something. The person behind someone. So this seems right. Let us start with that one. The principal driving force behind meteorite studies is the fact that small bodies such as asteroids and comets are most likely to. Now you bring that word preserve. Preserve what? Evidence of events that took place in the early solar system. So based on that, what is the answer? AC, am I right? Which option says that? That is the answer. That doesn't matter. Next one. Lizards. We all know lizards. Better not to talk about lizards. That is the expression. Lizards occupy diverse vegetation. Lizards occupy. There is no problem. But diverse vegetation, I don't think that is right. Occupy diverse vegetation. What is the burrows? And what is the last one? Habitats. Occupy animals. We use the word habitats. So we'll start with that word. Lizards occupy a diverse... Lizards occupy diverse habitats that range from underground warrens and burrows to the surface and elevated vegetation. So what is the answer based on that? Again, the fifth option. Here, BD, which option is that? Fourth option. BD. The next one, some, still with lizards, some rely slowly. Rely slowly, does it sound right? No. What is the right word? Move. Some move slowly and rely on cryptic coloration. Underline the word cryptic. Cryptic language means what? Coded language, secret language. Cryptic coloration for protection, whereas others can run swiftly. Swiftly means what? Quickly. Across desert sands. So what is the answer here? A and B. Which option says that? Now the last one. Oil, coal and other fossil fuels are produced. No. Are power. Are burned. You need a verb in past participle form. Industries. So, oil, coal and other fossil fuels are burned to power. Here power is a verb. Please make a note. To power our vehicles and what? produce electricity for our homes and industries. So what is the answer here? Which option is that? That's it for today.